beneath you like water, mercy and light. Come and be closer, without you I die. Need you like water, mercy and light. Without you I die. Need you like water, mercy and light. Come and be closer, without you I die. Need you like water, mercy and light. Follow me, love. Follow me, mercy. Follow me, grace. Father, I'm thirsty. Follow me, love. Follow me, mercy. Follow me, grace. 'Cause Father, without you I die. I need you like water, mercy and light. Come and be closer. Without you I die. I need you like water, mercy and light. Mercy and light. Mercy and light.
I like that.
We're back.
Acoustic energy. Acoustic energy. Whoa, yeah. Wait a minute. What is happening here?
So the other week, I just had a one shoulder because I got it.
Which wasn't working.
No, no, no.
The one shoulder was bad.
Listen to me. People messaged and called me and saw me on the street.
That's because they're your friends.
And said, nah.
Nobody likes them. Nobody likes it.
Trust me. Give me the beat. Give me the beat.
Oh my gosh.
Give me the beat. Give me the beat.
Acoustic energy. Acoustic. Why am I doing it?
You're digging.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Acoustic Energy. My name is Dale.
And my name is Joe, and we're so happy that you have joined us tonight.
Yes, yes, yes.
It is going to be an absolutely amazing show. We are showcasing Berman University from Alberta. We are wearing some Berman merchandise, but you probably can't see it because, well, mine is white on white.
Mine is black on black.
But
it's dope. It's nice. I really like it.
It's really, really nice.
Really cool.
So to start off our show, we are going to have a word. A short word by Pastor Lyle Notice.
When I think about music, for me, it's powerful because my first interaction with DJing and beat making was when I was in my teens and at this place called The Playground, downtown Toronto. I remember DJ Lil Jazz teaching how to make beats and how to scratch. DJs have a process of sampling, of making beats. And one of the first things that you gotta do is you gotta find a record. DJs will dig in the crates. They'll go back, way back in time, and sometimes looking for hours, searching, crate digging for that record. And I mean, we're talking about Motown, we're talking about Mozart, we're talking about some of the oldies, some stuff that we've never really remembered since it was first played. But it seems like it's some of the old stuff that makes the greatest new stuff. And so the process is this. You first find the record. You then have got to trim the sound that you've taken because you can't use all of it, right? You've got to use a select sort of portion. After trimming, you've got to chop it. And that's literally when you cut the actual piece of the sound that you're going to use. Once you chop it, next thing you gotta do is you flip it. And so you use it in such a way that it's new. It's literally brand new. You're literally taking this piece of old record, this old sound, flipping it into something new that becomes like a hit for everybody to listen to. And I see it the same way with God. He literally finds us. He finds the people who are discarded, the people who have been passed over, the people that have been left literally in the past. And he takes them and then he trims them. He trims off the fat. He trims off things that are no longer relevant to his purpose. once he's done that, he chops the very best pieces within us. And you know what he does next? He flips it. He literally takes that thing and spins it into something new. God is like the ultimate crate digger. He's the greatest at finding old pieces that become new life. And so allow God to find you, trim you, chop you, flip you, make you into something new. Something from your past, turn it to something that's a part of your beautiful future. God bless you.
Hey guys, my name is Alessandro Del Piero Coronado Pajuelo. I'm a religious studies student here at Berman University in my fourth year. I live in Barrie, Ontario, but currently here at Berman University. I would just like to extend our gratitude to Acoustic Energy for hosting our university today. I know our campus may seem far away from where you are, but please feel free to reach out to us by sending us an email to info@bermanu.ca for a virtual tour. We'll be more than happy to show you our campus. We're still accepting applications for our winter semester, so please be sure to contact us and we'll get right back at you.
Our first artist for this evening goes by the name Stanisha Diligence. Now listen, she has been singing all her life. Her father was a choir director at church, so she always had the opportunity to sing, right? Performing is what she was born to do. She admires many singers from all over the world. Sandy Patty, Kim Burrell, Jennifer Hudson, Aretha Franklin, Beyonce, Yolanda Adams. Now listen, I heard Stanisha. I know what you guys are in for this evening. Put your hands together wherever you are. Sit back, relax, and enjoy Miss Stanisha Diligence.
Joelle and Dale, you guys look good. You guys are doing such an amazing job at hosting this beautiful program. And I'd like to take the time out to give a special thanks to the brains behind the Acoustic Energy for giving me the opportunity to minister to you, the great audience. You guys are amazing and you guys are blessing me by being here because you're here giving your time, watching me and others minister and talk about how God has been good to us. I trust that as I sing this song, you receive it as a blessing that you can carry out through the new week. And yes.
What if I choose the wrong thing? crying out to you, Lord, I know that you're the only one who is able to pull me through. Guide me until I'm sure, oh, to ask you for, oh, especially today when my world is cloudy.
Kenan Swain, he's originally from the beautiful island of the Bahamas. He's actually a recent graduate of Berman with a bachelor's degree in health sciences. I was able to hear this young man perform, and his talent is definitely amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, Kenan Swain.
Hello, everybody. My name is Kenan Swain. I want to say a special thanks to Joel and Dale and also to Acoustic Energy for having me a part of this show. I want to say a special thanks to the audience for showing much love. Today I'll be playing for you Amazing Grace, a melody of Amazing Grace, and As the Deer. Hope you are blessed.
Thank you. everyone. My name is Romanda Carey. I'm a fourth year theology major at Berman University. I'm super excited that I'm almost graduated, but I'm a little saddened by the fact that I'm going to be ending my tenure here with these amazing humans that I have grown to call family over the past 4 years. This place is amazing. Amazing. And I've gotten the chance to grow in so many capacities. I've served as the executive vice president of the Student Association. I've served as music and worship director. I'm currently the director of Ubuntu. Ubuntu is a Zulu word, which means I am because we are. And that's the name of a choir that specializes in Negro spirituals. We celebrate the fact that culture is just another way in which we experience God, and that there is a place for every culture in worship. I'm also currently serving as the student chaplain of this university, and it's an amazing opportunity to walk alongside so many people that love Jesus and people who are also seeking Jesus. I'm going to share with you today a song called The Lord's Prayer. I hope that is a blessing.
The shoulder goes down, not up. You're
going
up.
Stop. I'm not doing this shoulder thing. It's not cool. It's not my thing.
So today's sponsor for our giveaway is Ohema Natural. They are a movement that wholeheartedly believes in building up kings and queens in every aspect of life.
Yes, they do.
They create luxurious natural hair and body products. I saw the gift that is being given away, and one of the things in it was a king-size whipped cocoa butter.
Ooh, that's nice.
It smells sweet.
That is nice.
A few house rules before I give the question. First things first, if you've already won, unfortunately, you cannot win again. Secondly, to win, you have to write into the chat, and our chat administrator will notify you that you've won and will tell you what you need to do to claim your gift.
Yes.
So here is the question. Are you ready? Give me a longer drum roll.
A longer drum roll.
Yeah. On last week's show, we had Kevin Lemons. What is the name of his choir? What is the name of Kevin Lemons' choir? And
go.
These artists are so inspiring. Acoustic Energy is an online platform that aims to create a safe space for artists to share their stories, showcase their gifts, and express love to our creator in a global space. We are dedicated to improving our community through the arts. This is why we rely on donations from viewers just like you. Your donations help towards purchasing equipment and to fund the operation of this growing organization. We invite you to donate by e-transferring to give at acousticenergy.tv or visit us on our website at acousticenergy.tv under the button Give. Together, we can continue to make Acoustic Energy a reality. Enjoy the show.
Set encampments around me. angel armies has set encampments round me. Whom shall I fear? Oh.
I would like to welcome the director of Remnant Creative Arts, Sri Knight Notice. Hey, Sri, how are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm doing well. I can't complain. How's the weather out there?
Actually, Alberta has been very unkind and rude. So Shocking. We just got major snowfall last week.
Excuse me?
And it's supposed to snow again today. So
we're in October.
it was 20 degrees like 2 weeks ago. So like, it's just, this is Alberta. It might be 20 degrees tomorrow and we might get like a blizzard on Thursday. It's just, I don't know. We might get a blizzard any day of the week.
So when would be the best time to travel out there?
To Alberta?
Yes.
You can get snow in any month of the year. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So I guess I won't be buying a ticket.
You're not coming out here.
So I just wanted to talk to you real quickly about your group, Remnant Creative Arts. I just want to know, where did this idea come from? How did you guys start this group?
So I have been the director of some sign language choirs at the school I used to teach at, Mount Royal Tascatin Native School. It was a native school. And I also was the director of a sign language group at Berman University called Unspoken Testimony. So those were really cool opportunities. And so I decided I'm going to bring those two groups together to do a performance. Okay. And one of my friends was into acrobatics. And I loved what they used to do with the acrobatics. And I was just like, hey, let's do one song together where you do the acrobatics. And then we have like, you know, my kids from the school. And then we also have like the Berman University girls performing as well. Let's just do like one big mashup and then have like drama. Okay. And so I remember he looked at me, his name is like Richard Gray, and he was looking at me, he's like, you're crazy. Like, that's not ever done. I was like, well, we're going to do that. So we ended up putting that together and it was really, really well received. So from then we started to do small projects and then we just decided that we were going to make this a permanent thing. So for the last like 2 years, we've kind of been really a cohesive group and we're still trying to figure out like how to manage and how to make this work in the pandemic and with students all over the place. But yeah.
Absolutely. So earlier you said that you taught or you were doing you had a sign language group at Berman, correct?
Yeah.
So my question is, I'm moving more to the dance side. How do you guys determine choreography for the different pieces that you put on?
So here's like a group secret. Everybody knows like I'm actually one of the worst dancers like in the group, but I'm the director, right? So what ends up happening is I do a lot of research online. I look to see what other people are doing. Mm-hmm. And I have one of my friends, her name is Pastor Jordan Smith. She's the lead choreographer. And so she really does come up with a lot of the dance moves. And then I'm able to show them like, hey, look what, you know, this person is doing. Can we do that?
Okay,
is it like thing that like people don't actually do? So that's kind of how we do it. We do collaboration, but I do have a lead choreographer and she's amazing at what she does. And I just try not to look silly and terrible when we do things together.
I don't know if you've seen our previous show, but Dale was talking about my dance moves and how spectacular they are. So if you do need a choreographer, I'm there. Just let me know. Contact Dale, and then he'll set it up.
I got you. You know what? Like we have something coming up soon. I should feature you. So
I think I might be busy. I might be busy that time, that exact time that you need me. But we'll work out the details off camera.
We'll work on it.
So let me ask you this: with such a different type of group, what has been your biggest challenge to date? Merging dance and the sign language?
I think for me, the biggest challenge, it's because it's not just dance and sign language. To me, that would be the easy part. It's dance, it's sign language, it's acrobatics, it's drama. And so trying to make all those things to one cohesive like visual arts picture to me is something that's been one of the most difficult things. But actually the most difficult challenge I've had to face, because we've been through a lot. We've had leaders just kind of up and quit. We've had like a lot of like, infighting and that kind of stuff when you have like these kind of groups. But the most difficult challenge for me is just being able to lead when I feel broken. I think what's one of those things that people oftentimes don't talk about, but as ministers, we oftentimes are put in situations where we have to navigate through actually having a personal life and going through things personally and
Absolutely.
still feeling like we have to lead spiritually and lead other people into what they need from you. So I've had a miscarriage, I've had marital problems, I've switched jobs, and in the last year it just felt like everything in my life was a shamble. And so I was having anxiety attacks, I lost something like 15 to 20 pounds. It was a lot. It was a lot to deal with. And yet still there were 40 people who were looking to me for guidance. And I felt like I had nothing. I felt like I didn't have what it took to be a leader. And I remember like that was one of the biggest challenges. And I remember God saying to me that it's not about me being perfect. It's not about me being, the best dancer or having all the skills. It's the fact that like he's given me a vision. And like he's expecting that in the midst of my brokenness, that that vision is still something that he expects of me to be obedient to.
That's
And
really
so
powerful.
that's something I struggle with, but that's something that like I believe will always be one of my biggest challenges, but it's also the thing that keeps me humble through everything.
So I'm guessing this might have been a little challenge for you guys as well, because a lot of churches, I know a lot of churches with West Indian background,
Yes.
they view dance in church like, have you
Terrible.
guys
You're going to
how have you
Okay,
guys
you're going
some
to Get it. Just
people
God's leading
are
you
like
to be
nodding right
perfect.
now saying yeah I know you are, but how have you guys used this to change their negative view of dance and acrobatics and stuff like that in the church?
I think for me, it's actually opened their eyes up to see that not all dance takes place like in a club and that kind of stuff. I believe that we have this negative viewpoint of dance more so because of where our like family members and the actual church members came from. So they're bringing their own negative viewpoint of like the fact that like yeah, you were shaking it in the club, but like that doesn't mean that like everybody, that's how we do dance. So I think for them to see that it could be impactful, that it can like involves a lot of emotion, that they
Absolutely.
can see that a lot of the people who come through the group, they've been changed. A lot of parents may not have wanted their kids to be a part of the group, but because their kids were a part of the group, they were able to get better grades, they were better leaders, they were able to revitalize their spiritual lives. So I think they've been able to see that there's a lot of benefit and merit to the group. And so to me that's what's most important is that the lives are being affected and changed. And when the people's lives are affected and changed, it's hard to argue with that. It's hard to keep your old viewpoint when people are coming to Jesus, when people are actually seeing God in a different light, when people are actually becoming better people because of a ministry.
You are so right. And with that being said, as we wrap up this amazing interview, and first thing first, I'd like to thank you just for being a part of Acoustic Energy. The last question I want to have I have for you is, do you have any words of advice for someone that may want to try something different? Because you're doing something different. Do you have any words of advice for someone that wants to try something different but might be a little held back or nervous? What advice would you give them?
So, the one thing I would tell people is this. We got our name Remnant because of a quote that I had seen, and it says, sometimes the remnant aren't the ones that stay behind, but they're the ones that leave. And I believe that remnant, being a remnant, is movement. And I believe that if God has given you a vision, it might require you to not be in a comfortable position, to not stay where you are. It most often requires you to be the one to break apart from what is most often comfortable or what people have seen as tradition. And so to me, I believe that if you want to follow God, then it's going to require you to make that decision to be the remnant, to be the one to break apart. And that's where all the change happens. It's hard, it's difficult, but to me, it's harder to live outside of the will of God and outside of God's vision for you than it is to actually walk in it and to be able to know that you're doing what God has called you to do. So I tell everybody to just do it. That oftentimes other people may not understand it, but mm-hmm. that probably means that you're on the right path, and it means that there's somebody out there who needs what you have. And if you don't do it, then somebody is not going to be able to meet Jesus the way that you could. Like, Absolutely. You're literally, there's somebody relying on you to start that new ministry. There's someone relying on you to start that new group. There's someone relying on you to do what God has called you to do. You know, worship is obedience.
I really, really hope those that are listening that may have been nervous about starting something, you have been able to watch this interview and take something from it. I'd like to thank you so very much for being a part of our show. It was a true honor and a blessing to have you guys. And I feel like you guys should, or not you guys, you, it'd be an amazing idea if you could shoot to this world premiere video that we have of Remnant Creative Arts.
All right, so introducing the world premiere of Remnant Creative Arts video, Stand For Me, and that's a song by Jonathan Traylor. We hope that you enjoy it. We hope that you are blessed by it and that you remember that you need to stand up for something.
Grief and outrage in Texas after a white police officer fatally shot an African-American woman inside her own home.
Tatiana Jefferson, 28 years old, died on the spot in her bedroom early Saturday morning.
Northern California, where there is growing outrage over a fatal police shooting, officers opening fire on an unarmed black man in his grandparents' backyard.
Last moments of Ahmaud Arbery's life as he was jogging through a Georgia neighborhood in February.
It has happened again in America. A black man in police custody pleads for help as he struggles to breathe. George Floyd, accused of check forgery, is pressed down, his face bloody. He later dies in police custody.
For me, who will stand for me? what is drowning deep in sin. I ask who will stand for me. Who will stand for me? In a world that's crying out for truth, in a world that's crying out for proof, who will stand for me? Who will stand for me? Yeah. Who will stand out and be the light? Who will fight for what is right? Who in here will stand firm on my word and testify? See, I will, I sure will. I will let the whole world know that you're real and you're God here coming back for your people.
Stand for me.
Crucial period of your lives, for what you do now and what you decide now at this age may well determine which way your life shall go. A deep belief in your own dignity, your own worth, and your own somebodyness. Don't allow anybody to make you feel that you are nobody. Always feel that you count. Always feel that you have worth. And always feel that your life has ultimate significance.
Time to go home, my brother. We've come to the end of the show, and it was a pretty good show today. Berman University
came
showed
out. I know that they are definitely watching in Alberta. Yes. I'm not sure if it's raining, if it's probably snowing.
In Alberta, I'm sure.
Sorry, guys, if you're cold. But thank you for being a part of our show. We truly appreciate you all. We'd like to thank the audience for watching. Without you guys, we do not have a show. So thank you so very much for watching. Exactly. I'd also like to thank our sponsor, Ohema Natural. Please go out and support, on their Facebook and Instagram pages. We will post their information at the bottom.
And for those who are still inquiring as to how to support this ministry, feel free to go to give@acousticenergy.tv and support this ministry. If you're in America where you use Cash App, you can still use Cash App using give@acousticenergy.tv. And along with that, guys, please keep up with us on Facebook and on Instagram. We're going to be posting material on Facebook and on Instagram. And don't forget to tune in for the next Acoustic Energy. It's going to be really good.
It's going to be a really good show.
As long as you stop doing that show.
No, but especially for the next show?
No, you can't. You can't.
But for the people that we have.
No shoulder moves. And I know you've been practicing your shoulder moves.
I guarantee you all, I'm coming with a new move.
Nope, it's not new a move. Thing. No, don't.
So for the last time.
I'm done.